Yeah. Hold on a minute. A little lightheaded. Holy shit! They're bringing another A7M to War Thunder. The erections are big. My heart is beating fast. I am so excited. I mentioned recently, and by recently I mean pre-patch 1.53, that the addition of an A7M would be one of my favorite additions to War Thunder. I really wanted the A7M in War Thunder. In my 45 units I'd like to see video I did in Talking War Thunder, it was one of the vehicles on that list, the A7M. I might have said A7M1, but I meant A7M altogether. The A7M is one of those vehicles that's like, holy shit, put this in the damn game, because it's fucking amazing. It's one of those kind of aircraft that really didn't do the fighting thing because it didn't really have a chance, but that's what makes it spec-fucking-tacular. I think it's a beautiful aircraft, and I think it would be a perfect place in War Thunder. Previous update, we got a premium A7M added to the game, the A7M1 NKH shit, some sort of engine thing. Now, they're bringing the A7M2 to the game, the Japanese tech tree. Not only is this great to see that it's not just British ground forces, but we're also getting things for aviation pilots, but it's also great to see a new Japanese aircraft. The Japanese need shitloads more planes. They had shitloads more than they have in the game now, but they need more. The only reason it takes a little longer is because it's harder to find information on them for Gaijin Entertainment, so anytime I see a Jap... Anytime I see any... I cut off half sentence. Anytime I see any aircraft added to any nation, I'm super happy, but especially for the Japanese, because anytime I see any new Japanese aircraft, it's spectacular because they don't have many, and it's great to see what kind of special aircraft they shit out back in the day that are now being shit out into War Thunder that I'm going to play and be shit in. The A7M2, of course, is a slightly, I'd assume to be a slightly better variant than the A7M1. Which sits at a battle rating of 3.3 in realistic battles in War Thunder now. It has two 20mm cannons and two 13mm machine guns, all wing-mounted. So let's see what this thing has to offer. I'm hoping for big things. It says, "Hello, friends! We would like to continue to brief you about the aircraft which will soon appear in our game. There are many fans of Japanese planes among our players, but there aren't many of the aircraft themselves." Which is completely true. "This is why we try to expand their tech tree and gradually add new planes to the game. Say hello to the A7M2 fighter." I haven't read any of this yet, so this is all like blind shit, and I am super excited. "Unfortunately, the Japanese aviation tech tree does not have enough aircraft at every rank, which is something that we are trying to rectify. We have already added the A7M1, the prototype of the carrier fighter, as a premium plane. We are now adding the A7M2 to the main line of Japanese carrier fighters. The aircraft has excellent technical and flight characteristics, and we are sure that our players will enjoy it." Okay, so something to point out right now, this is not a premium aircraft. This will be going straight onto the standard tech tree as a naval fighter. So get your... whip your willies out and start cleaning up now, because I don't know how to explain it. I'm so excited. Like, holy shit, I don't think I've been so excited for other aircraft before. You do not know how excited I am to see another A7M in the game. I love it, and this is a standard one, which means I don't have to fuck up money for it. Even though I still want to fuck over money for that A7M1, but still. Oh, shit. We're getting so much closer, guys. So many units that I want in the game are coming to the game. Oh, God. Okay. Continuing on, "Some of the external features of its predecessor, the A6M, can be seen in the A7M2. However, the aircraft definitely increased in size and changed its shape, which is obvious. It also has a little bit of a bent wing thing going on. The A7M2's size and wingspan are really large for a carrier-based aircraft, which is obvious. Obviously, where it's bent is where it would clip and then fold over. Is there anything else? Oh, shit. Yeah, there is. And we got a little bit of a video here. Alright, it says, "The production variant of the A7M with index number 2. Unlike the prototype, which you already know about, this aircraft had the more powerful MK9A engine with an output of 2,200 horsepower and a reinforced frame. The weight increase is compensated for by the new engine. So the aircraft inherited all of the best characteristics of its predecessor. The maximum speed has increased to 629 kilometers an hour, while the climb rate has remained the same. There have also been no changes to the handling and maneuverability of the plane. This will be a very powerful weapon, even if it is in the hands of an inexperienced pilot. So imagine what a real samurai will be able to do with it. Holy shit. So it's keeping the same shit, I'm assuming same 20mm cannon, same 13mm machine guns, but it basically is faster now, which is perfectly fine with me. I haven't flown the A7M1, of course, because I don't own it, but I have seen it in battle-ish, not really, but I know that it can really pack a punch, and I know I am going to love the shit out of this plane. I think it is one of the most beautiful aircraft to ever be produced in World War II, even if it wasn't technically produced. I still think it is one of the most beautiful aircraft I've ever seen out of that era of aircraft, especially for Japanese aircraft. And a lot of Japanese aircraft look beautiful. So let's take a look at this video here. Oh, look at it. Very maneuverable. Did you hear those guns? This thing's gonna wreck things. Oh, this thing's going to be great in arcade and realistic. Can't say about simulator because I still can't fly that, sad face. I am going to love the shit out of this thing. So, I wasn't actually expecting to have... Well, we didn't get a dev blog post yesterday, which is a little depressing. We got one... You see, we got one on the 3rd, the 4th, and then the 5th, but we didn't get one on the 6th. I was expecting another British tank, but... We got one on the 7th, not a British tank, but hey, it's a new aircraft, which I was totally not expecting any new aircraft on the way for the next update. So this is definitely a welcome addition. And I hope a lot of you are also going to be excited for the A7M2. If you are, post down below. If there's something else you'd love to see added to the game, post down below. Feel free to share any information, anything like that. I cannot wait for this update. I'm going to play the shit out of the British Ground Forces, and I'm going to be playing the shit out of the Japanese now to get this thing. And I'm going to fly it right away, and I'm going to record my first flight, and you're going to watch me suck with it, something like that. So if it does have something like that, well, if it's similar to the A7M1, I'm assuming it's going to be around the same battle rating, maybe 3.7, 3.3 area. I hope it doesn't go anywhere like over that. So I can't wait to see this thing in battle, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.